Welcome back to STS. In today's video, we're going to find the inverse function of a rational function. All right, let's begin by saying that our rational function is f of x is equal to, we have a numerator of 5x plus 2, and our denominator is the quantity x minus 3. Of course, our first step is to take that f of x notation and change that into a y. So we have y is equal to 5x plus 2 over the quantity x minus 3. Second thing to do is to swap the x's and y's. So this y here becomes an x, and these x's here are going to become y. So the numerator becomes 5y plus 2 over y minus 3. And the third thing is to solve for y. All right. And solving for y, first thing I'm going to do is cross multiply. So here I'm going to have x times y minus 3, times the quantity y minus 3, is equal to 1 times 5y plus 2, which is just the 5y plus 2. All right, at this point, I need to go ahead and distribute this x to both terms. So here I have xy minus 3x is equal to 5y plus 2. And now I'm going to gather all the terms that have y or have a factor of y on one side and everything else on the other. So let's go ahead and add 3x to both sides. All right, in doing that, that cancels. And now I've got xy is equal to 5y plus 2 plus 3x. And now let's get this 5y to the other side. So I'm going to subtract 5y from both sides. So it cancels here. And I've got xy minus 5y is equal to 2 plus 3x. I'm going to rewrite everything up here. So xy minus 5y is equal to 2 plus 3x. Here I've got a common factor of y, so let's factor out a y. So I'm left with x minus 5 is equal to 2 plus 3x. And now I can get this y by itself by dividing by the quantity x minus 5. All right, those cancel. And I'm left with y is equal to 2 plus 3x over the quantity x minus 5. And if I put that in the notation using the f, I see that the inverse of the original function is, let me change this around, 3x plus 2. You know, when I add, the order doesn't matter, over x minus 5. So this here is, in fact, the inverse derived. Now let's take a look at the calculator. All right, with the calculator, notice that I have in the first equation position, the line of symmetry y equals x. In the second position, which is the red, I've got the original equation. And in the third position, in black, I have the inverse. And now let's just click on graph so we can see what this looks like. There's the blue for the line of symmetry. Here's the red, which is the original function. And then here comes the black, which is our inverse. And notice that we do have symmetry with respect to this diagonal line here, y equals x. And let's just put in a few values just to test out what we have here. So second quit, and let's clear out what I have. Let's click on alpha and then press F4. We know the second equation was the original equation. Let's put in, let's say, a value of 4. And we see that the output is 22. Let's switch that now. So we're going to take a look at the inverse, and which is in position 3. Now for the inverse, I'm going to use the output value from the original function. And my output here should be a 4 for my inverse. And we see that it is. And let's just do one more. Let's go back to the original function. Let's put in, let's say, 100. And when the input is 100, we end up with a improper fraction. Let's take a look at the inverse, which is in position 3. Let's use the arrow to get up there so we can grab that improper fraction. So now that's the input of the inverse, and we're expecting our output to be 100. And here we see our output is 100. All right, so that sums it up for this video of inverses with rational functions. Please subscribe to that YouTube channel. And as always, thank you for watching.